is it realistic? Is there any reason to believe now that this might be a possibility, that we might start to see aid getting in?
We've got to see aid getting in. One thing that we can start with is each week having a 48-hour pause in the fighting to allow the aid to go through. That was a proposal that the UN made a couple of months ago. The Russians were against it, but they are now in favor of it. So I hope that everyone can agree that. And as I said in the Security Council just now, if we can agree on that, we can all come together and to begin to get the aid in to the people of Aleppo. They need that so much. And then secondly, there must be a halt to the bombing, a halt to the fighting. The Syrian regime and their Russian backers have got to stop the fighting. And if they do that, then the political talks can get going again.
So if the Russians, in principle, I mean, as recently as last week, they were saying that they are on board with the principle of this 48 ceasefire, what's the holdup? What needs to happen now to actually make this take place on the ground?
Well, the UN relief chief told us today that the UN are ready to go ahead. So as soon as there is a pause agreed in Syria, then the aid will start flowing again. Not a single convoy of aid has got into Aleppo in the whole month of August. And there are thousands upon thousands of people there who desperately need it. So the UN are ready to go. And provided that the Russians can agree to allow these pauses, then they will go ahead. Unfortunately, there is a difference between actions and words. And we've had the words before, and what we now need is the actions. And that means genuine pause to the fighting. And let's hope that it's for more than 48 hours. Let's hope that we begin with 48-hour pauses and that they increase in regularity and in length and until there is a proper, genuine ceasefire to allow all aid to get into all the people who need it.